Today we're going to look at how we can use App Connect to insert a set of contacts into Salesforce from a CSV parser. First, we're going to create a new API. We're going to give the model a name, and we're going to have one property on our model, which is the URL of the file that we want to load. And this is going to be a file that we've got inside a box. Going to create one operation on here, which is to create as a post, and I'm going to implement that. And you can see here that this is the package of data we're going to send up with just that URL inside of it. I'm going to say that I want to go and read a file from box, and the ideal of the file is going to be the last part of the URL. So I'm going to take that and apply a function to it, and I'm going to split it. I'm going to split it based on a slash character, and I want to take the last entry. And that's a JSON R2 expression we've just written there. So now I've retrieved exactly one file from box that matches the request, and I'm going to apply parsing logic to it. You can see we currently support JSON and CSV. I'm going to choose CSV here, and I'm going to say that I want to parse the CSV that came in from the retrieved file. Scroll down, see all the properties that I have here. I'm going to choose the file content. I'm going to say the first row of the data is a header, and I'm going to paste it into App Connect to teach App Connect about the format. Paste that in and generate a schema. So that means that all of the downstream logic now is going to know about all of the fields that are inside of that CSV. So what that means is now I can do a for each piece of processing to say, for every one of those items that I've just processed from that box file, I'd like to apply a piece of logic to that. I'll select that there, and now I can click here, and I can choose to go and insert all of those into Salesforce. Let's see here, what I'm going to actually do is I'm going to say I'd like to process all of those in parallel. Okay, so I can now go down to Salesforce here. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to create some contacts. So I'm going to update or create contacts, so basically an upsert operation. Let's move this over here so we've got more space. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to update when the item matches. So add a first name inside of the CSV data, last name inside of that CSV data, and let's use the email address as well. Okay, and what I'm going to do is obviously just update those create or update a record that matches. Type the naming city, set my postcode, okay. So now what I've got is a flow here, which will, when a request comes in, retrieve a file from box, process it with CSV parser, for each record inside of there in parallel, go and send an update to Salesforce. Last thing I just need to do is to pass back a response. So I'm just going to very simply pass back the URL that came in. So now I can go ahead and start that API. And I can go to the Manage panel. And you see here that I have the built-in API Connect capabilities. And what I'm able to do is just create myself an API key for testing. Have an API key down here. Drop it into the clipboard. I could open up the test interface for this. I can say I'd like to try it, paste in that client ID, and what I can do here is remember that body that I needed to put in here. I can just take that, and in this case, just take that file URL that I'd like to pass in, pass that in here. Inside Salesforce, don't have any contacts. I just call that operation, wait for the response. There we go, successful request. Click here, click a refresh, and you can see all of those items from the CSV have been created.